Hey guys and gals, Striker here, and today I am going to be playing one of the first games I ever live streamed or recorded. Hitman. Alright. I'm going to get Robert Knox first, and I put a sniper in here, right? Let's go.
That is Ted Mendez, one of the country's most influential military-grade money men. This must be connected to Kronstadt.
I don't think anyone's gonna see it. Let me just... Yeet. Alright, let's go. There's a fly.
Mr. C, sir.
Get out of your fly.
The demonstration is scheduled to take place on the upper floors.
Think I'm gonna whack him and whack him. Alright.
Hello, HR? Yes, it's Ben Wheeler down at the Bayside Center. Listen, I realize this may sound trivial, but the fountain
you're coming on a little strong, and I don't feel the same. Back
off,
please. I
can't work without my energy drinks, and I have been.
Wow, Mountain Dew, Fountain View.
It's right in here, Mr. Mendez.
Greetings, sir.
Ted Mendez, right? I wasn't told you were here, but I'm glad to see you. Let's go. Let me show you the future. Ah, Ted, good to finally see you. Guess traffic was rough. Ah, never mind. Let me show you everything. I'm gonna say something provocative now, Ted. War is going out of fashion. It's dirty. It's just plain bad PR. Nobody wants to exchange their children and of ones for flags and medals anymore. The glory is gone, Ted. But luckily, Kronstadt has a solution for that. Imagine this.
Look at me.
Operating in the field, disguised.
I don't even have glasses.
Embedded, ready to strike at a moment's notice. Indestructible robotic operators.
I wonder if they did that purposely.
The deepest sanctuary of any adversary. Striking an unseen fatal blow. A surgical tool for a blunt world. Imagine an army of them. Fully equipped android medics seeking out wounded servicemen and injured civilians, bringing them to safety, patching them up then and there.
Greetings, sir.
And we'll do the rest.
Target acquired. Dummy B.
Obviously, the final system won't rely on you manually using biometric data. This is still a prototype. This is a pivotal moment
in modern conflict solution, Ted. Palace is entirely foolproof. All you need is to pick a photo from the table and scan it just like I showed you.
It's perfectly safe.
This thing will app again. So, Mr. Mendez, impressive so far, yeah? Let me quickly show you our on-site robotics lab. It's small, but state-of-the-art, and it's fully mobile, so you can deploy it anywhere.
I miss so much.
Robert knocks down.
A Neo
now for the heir to the Kronstadt Empire.
We lost visual on the target.
Run, 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 run. Open up.
What is that stuff anyway?
Boom. Boom. get out of here. Don't want to kill anybody else, though.
So that's Bruno Diaz.
See that red car, 47? That's the Kronstadt race car with Sierra Knox behind the wheel.
Don't forget, this race is all about getting some miles under the hood. It's as much about the car's stamina and technology as it is about the driver's...
47, the race is over. Sierra will be coming off the track anytime.
Oh, I didn't know you could do that. Let's go. All right, where's Sierra Knox? Slip all the way over there. That's why we have sponsors. Shut up.
Stay with me.
That's right, sir. Just keep going, please.
Mark III. This particular car is the first production.
All right, that was it, sir.
It's identical to the one.
Please get back to whatever you were doing
these past 2 days. But the very first one, it's a bit special for Mr. Knox, so he won't allow it.
Open.
Hey, you! Where do you think you're going?
Definitely not through here.
Oh, Neono.
Yes. Jim, it's me. I'm here now, ready to meet up with Sierra Knox over at the hotel. Yeah, after the race. I've just got to pick up the documents from my van, but I had to knock out a guy and steal his flamingo outfit. Now I can't find my car keys. Yeah, I know it's dumb. I think I lost them in the scuffle, but the real mascot is still over there. If I don't get them, I've got no evidence. Bye-bye money. I don't know. I need to figure something out. Talk soon.
A disgruntled Kronstadt employee has acquired some dirt on Sierra Knox and intends on blackmailing her. Disguised as one of the racing mascots, he plans to meet Sierra by the old motel. Well, I always did feel that pink was your color, 47.
Gooch.
God damn! Help! Help me, please!
Oh, no, no, no! Just gonna... Let's get my briefcase. And that's escaped.
Oh, my head. Some guy jumped me. He stole my mascot outfit. Who would do that?
Oh, no, no. Not me. Over there. Looks like another way has to be found.
I know I'm not a rich man.
Oh, this way. Oh wait, no, I'm so confused. No, it was this way. Ugh, I'm so dumb. Okay, let's keep going.
See you, sir.
So enjoy the rest of your time here in wonderful.
There can be only one winner, and this year the trophy
goes to the very deserving
Moses Lee. Please join me in applauding his efforts and those of the entire Team Kowloon.
Nice outfit. Really brings out your eyes. So, did you bring the documents?
I have the papers right here.
Excellent. Come on in. Have a seat or something. I'll let Miss Knox bring you here.
So far, so good, 47. Now, let's see where this meeting is headed.
So, you here for a job application or what?
Something like that.
Nice. If you don't mind me saying so, your particular choice of attire is maybe a little, I don't know, off? For a job interview, I mean.
My suit is at the cleaners.
And you couldn't find anything else to wear?
Correct.
You must lead a very interesting life, my friend.
You have no idea.
Hey, Flamingo.
Yeah, my job, mostly consists of shooting people like you in the head, getting into gunfights. She hear ya or what, my guy? Yeah, what a loser.
So, mister. I never did catch your name.
Names are for friends.
Very well. Straight to the point in all business. Walk with me.
Where are we going?
Don't worry. What am I gonna do? Can't do sensitive business like this in front of an audience.
Good idea.
So just to get this straight. You claimed in your email to have somehow found internal reports that show Kronstadt's involvement in the Tungan Valley Massacre.
Sounds about right.
Let's be clear. You and I are having this meeting because my father doesn't need to know about this. It's just another undesired distraction. I don't care if the information is true or false. I don't care if it mentions moving money from the Nexus Project into Tungan Valley Damage Control, as you claimed in your correspondence. I do care about protecting my father, which is why you and I are now here.
I see.
Leave me alone for a few minutes, guys.
Sure thing, Miss Knox. If you need us, just call. We're right around the corner.
So here's the deal. You hand over the documents and leave, and that's the end of it. And you will do that now. So here are the two possible outcomes of this meeting. One, you will leave this place and this country for good, and that will be the end of it.
And two, you die. Bye.
Both targets down. Well done, 47. Head for an exit, and we'll speak again soon.
Yeah, that's White Birdman. Nobody messes with Bad Dad. You're lucky you're not extinct.
We'll see about that when you find your dead body.
I'm telling you, Miss Knox is going to be
dead. Let's go! Yeah, Flamingo Boy. Alright guys, I hope you enjoyed this episode of Hitman, and I will see you later. Goodbye. Hey guys and gals, Shrek here, and thank you so much for watching this video. Leave a like, subscribe if you want, and I'll see you next time. Goodbye!